I'm Brook Lee, and this is Modern Wahine Hawaii. Welcome to Modern Wahine Hawaii, everybody. We are on the North Shore at Kōkua Hawaii Foundation's farm. I'm with Natalie McKinney. Hi, Natalie.
Hi.
So tell everybody what your position is here and what we're doing back here.
Yeah, so hi, I'm the Senior Program Director here at Kōkua Hawaii Foundation, and we're here on the Kōkua Leanring Farm. We recently, well, 2019, we acquired these 8 acres, mm-hmm. and we are doing programming here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the last time we came, you guys were just in the beginning processes. We were still deep in COVID, mm-hmm. and you know, things were sort of like, you don't know, waiting on permits, what have you.
Yes.
But since then, it's sort of blossomed, just like the farm.
Yes.
Progress has happened. So take us through some of the things that have changed since the last time.
Sure. So we've officially moved our offices here, which mm-hmm. is fantastic. It's great to be on site. I think when you were here, we were just kind of piloting a youth internship program. Mm-hmm. So we've done a full year of that with high school interns from Kahuku to Waialua,
nice.
Coming once a week. And then this summer we are doing another youth internship program, but we've invited middle school students as well.
Oh, wow.
And they're coming from as far as up Lelehua, Kahuku, and Waialua. So
nice.
Really opening up the place,
yes.
to them.
Yeah. Yes. And so what are some of the like different types of programs that you guys are going to be offering for everybody?
Yeah, so we're still doing our once a month community work days.
Yeah. And that's anybody. That's not just
anybody. Yeah. That's the first Saturday of the month. And those have begun to re-blossom,
right,
if you will.
Right.
So we're back up to like 60 people.
Nice.
Families coming from all over. And then on other Saturdays, we have private work groups. We work with Patagonia folks from across the street. They come once a month.
Oh, nice.
We also work with Chef Hui. They come once every other month and bring restaurant partners. And that's just been fantastic. We've since opened up the lo'i. Actually had one full harvest.
Wow.
So we've there were 3 varieties that we harvested. And Daniel, who's our caretaker on property, he pa'iai. And
nice.
We got to taste with all the interns, and it was so special.
Right.
So that's just been fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
So we're doing a constructive native wetland.
Yeah,
so,
and I heard it's all coming back.
Yes,
once you
it's
guys
all coming back.
Cleared it off. It kind of was like, oh, okay, we're on.
Yes.
And then they started bubbling up.
Yes. So we are in the heart of Haleiwa, but we're in the moku of Waialua.
Okay.
And so Waialua, 2 waters.
Right.
So we have the Waianae Mountain mm-hmm. Range here, and then the Ko'olau's are over there.
Right.
And if you know this place gets plenty water.
Yeah.
So we've created these bioswales around the perimeter.
Oh, wow.
And where we have planted natives.
Right.
And so this is where the water is being captured, as well as cleaned.
Yeah.
And then hopefully properly going back out to the
kai. Right, right,
mm-hmm.
right, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, once you guys started to bring it back and like shine it up a little bit, it knows what it's doing.
It
and
knows
so
what
once
it's doing.
You turn the engine,
yes.
they're like, vroom, 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 vroom,
yes.
and it just goes.
Yes.
So it's kind of interesting
yeah.
and so exciting to watch.
And it's so special. I was born and raised in this place.
Mm-hmm.
I went to Waialua High School. So just having people come here and be like, oh, wow, I,
right.
never knew
I didn't
this
even
place
know
existed.
This was here. Yeah.
Yeah. And then we have a partnership with Lokoea this summer.
Uh-huh.
So they're bringing their day camp students
oh,
here
nice.
For one day. And then we actually have Ho'ula Elementary School
aww.
That's coming. It'll be our first school field trip.
Nice.
Pilot.
Right.
but they're also a school that participates in our Aina in Schools program. So just really coming full circle, trying to bring our school programs, having things that are happening here on the farm.
Right.
Last year, we brought teachers
uh-huh.
To the farm, the teachers who participate and deliver the Aina in Schools lessons.
Yeah.
They came to get their training and real hands in the soil.
Right.
So it's just been a really, really amazing time for us.
I mean, the tool of the farm portion of, because you guys have always been doing outreach in the schools, and now that you guys have a place that is grounded here,
yes.
you can bring people here and really kind of get into it,
yes.
as opposed to taking it to them, which is really a great, great experience. So tell us a little bit about, you know, I know that you guys have a lot of projects going on, but you guys have a big, big benefit coming up because, you know, Farms aren't cheap.
Farms are not cheap.
Let's be honest, especially Moy Ne square footage wise. So tell everybody how, you know, how do you guys keep this whole endeavor flying?
Yeah, so we are extremely fortunate. Our founder is Kim Johnson, and her husband is Jack Johnson.
People may not know who he is.
He's
but yes.
a little singer-songwriter from Kahuku.
An indie guy.
You know, the way that they first started up with the funds for Kōkua Hawaii Foundation mm-hmm. was through the Kōkua Festival.
Right.
So that was our first fundraiser. Mm-hmm. So this year, Jack is back on tour.
Right.
He's touring the
because
continent.
Because nobody could for a
yes,
bit.
Yes, yeah. 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 And so when he comes to Hawaii for his Hawaii show, the Hawaii show will be a benefit for Kōkua Hawaii Foundation.
Got it.
So all of the proceeds from all the ticket sales will be coming back to us. And, you know, the thing about this place that is so special and that people might not know about all of our programs is our programs are all free.
Right.
So we give grants to schools. Mm-hmm. We have field trip grants and project grants for schools up to $1,000 per school per school year. Our Aina in Schools program, where we teach students farm to school initiatives around garden-based learning, nutrition, and composting.
Right.
No charge to the school. And so the benefit makes it possible for us to have these programs.
Right.
And to just have folks connect with their place.
And it's important that people know that when you go and get your tickets, the money that they're putting in there is coming directly here on the Aina to help touch the schools and Malama the Kiki.
Yes.
So it's really an important step of, yes, you're having a good time all the way over there in town in Waikiki, but your kala is helping us here in Haleiwa. So.
And it's gonna be an amazing community.
It's a pa'ina for everybody to just kind of celebrate and take a step back.
Because you know what happened the past 2 years and just everybody coming together and just celebrating life.
Right. Well, thank you so much for coming on the show and inviting us back. You know, we were so excited when we got the call and we're like, we moved in love, we're getting around Los Pao. And I was like, okay, let's come down and check it out. So we're glad to be here. So thank you for being here.
Thank you so much for having us and just continuing to shine the light on all things that are Hawaii and special.
Always down to come down to the farm. Don't go anywhere, we'll be right back. Welcome back to Mata Wahine Hawaii here in Haleiwa. I am with Anna Mathis, who's a program coordinator here at the farm. How are you?
I'm doing well.
So lots to talk about because you are kind of the heartbeat of the internship program here. And you guys are,
this
years?
Is our third session.
Third session strong.
Yeah.
So explain to people how that works in case, you know, they're watching, they're like, oh, an internship program over there. What's going on?
Yeah, so the farm started off with just community volunteers on the first Saturday. And then we rely so much on volunteers.
Yeah.
So we thought, hey, let's bring in the youth.
Right.
They're the future. So we opened it up to North Shore, keep it very local.
Mm-hmm.
They come one day a week on the school year.
Uh-huh.
And we harvest the veggie plots. They learn about soil amendments. We cook. We bring like outdoor cooking equipment out, and we harvest. Cook straight from the field.
Nice.
So one of our favorite things we cooked was beet poke.
Oh wow.
Which is so good. And we grew our own green onion, we grew the beets. So that was very nice and it was so delicious. And it also gives students and interns a way to connect with what they're growing.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just harvesting from the field and what are we doing with all of this? This is food. This is
and
dinner.
So with the internship program, just so that, you know, people might think, well, what if I don't know how to farm? It's for anybody. You don't have to be like a degree. You're going to go into agriculture or you grow things in your backyard. It's literally to teach people, maybe this might be something you might want to do later and try it out, kind of a thing, right? There's no prerequisite.
Yeah, we explore so many topics about agriculture. I'm very big into entrepreneurship.
Mm.
So I always try to tell the youth about different venues that they could use, like vermiculture.
Mm.
They could be selling, you know, worm castings and create something with that. You can make value-added products like skincare line. It doesn't have to be primarily just putting your hand, in the soil.
Got it. That's so great. And so what are some of the, I know you guys have so many like projects coming up. What are some of the like big projects that you guys have that you're focusing on?
One of my most favorite projects is our orchard that we're developing.
Mm.
It's an agroforest orchard. So we have some shrubs, we have plants, we have trees, we have a different types of herbs, and they all work together in kind of creating this ecosystem where it's low maintenance. Uh-huh. So we're expanding. Right now we have a citrus island.
Nice.
So tangerines, grapefruit, limes, tangelo.
And so when you're talking about that whole sort of holistic thing, it's sort of a different way of farming, because before it was like just rows of apples and nothing else.
Exactly.
Whereas now it's sort of like making sure that it's a whole ecosystem that's happening. So whatever's happening above in the trees can fall down,
yes,
and help what's happening below the trees.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of how nature intended it.
Yes.
Really, going back to the natural way,
exactly,
of doing things. Right.
We're mimicking the forest.
Yeah, which is kind of what an island is about.
Right?
Because we're not organized.
Yeah.
It's an island. Things,
yeah,
fall off the ground, they grow on the ground.
It's not straight.
Yeah. So that's amazing. And so what do you think is the key? What's so important about the schools getting involved here at the farm? What's at the heart of it all?
I believe what's at the heart of the Kōkua Leanring Farm is hands-on learning, mm-hmm, not just learning from worksheets or books about,
right,
ag and about plants. When you are on the farm, you can learn math, you can learn science. Mm-hmm. We do a lot of cultural relevancy,
right,
mo'olelo that we incorporate into our lesson.
Mm-hmm.
So it really is, it spans across all different sectors,
right,
all age levels, and kids are engaged because,
yeah,
they're doing
That's
something.
That's the key, right? Because when you're watching them when they're out here, it's a very different style of learning, but it actually is way more effective because,
mm-hmm,
one, they're not trapped in a classroom.
Yes.
And two, it's really practical because you can't be bored when you're actually picking something like, what am I supposed to do with this?
Yeah.
What do I do with it? Where do I put it? What do I wash with it? Can I eat it? I'm really impressed with the fact that, one, you know, this big rock star person started this movement and it grew and grew and grew and grew and grew, but mostly because he's really centric to make sure that this is where it all started for him and that all the schools around here, these kids have a vested interest. This is their backyard.
Yes.
They drive by here every day.
Yes.
They've grown up seeing this place not look like this, but so when they have skin in the game, it's kind of like, this is my neighborhood.
Yeah, and they take ownership,
right,
too. I have past interns who just came yesterday and they brought their little baby cousin.
Aww.
And was just trying to show them the farm.
Right.
And I could just see that little baby coming here in,
right,
you know, a couple years and playing on the farm. So it's very family friendly.
Uh-huh.
And all ages, all generations.
And so what would you say to some of the schools out there? Because I know how the Johnsons work. It's like you start with Halehiva.
Yeah.
And then it's the world. You take over the world. So like, what do you think is like, you know, what would you say to some of the schools out there who are like, oh, we've heard about this program, but we don't know, like, how would they get involved? Like, what are the steps?
Well, so we do offer field trip grants,
okay,
that cover bus and transportation as well.
Mm-hmm.
And they can get more information at kokuahuaifoundation.org.
Mm-hmm.
And then just give us a call and we're very flexible.
Right.
And if you want us to focus on, you know, social studies, science,
mm-hmm,
math, beekeeping,
right,
outdoor cooking,
right,
like this is, we want this to be your guys' farm too.
Nice. And so, and even so people are aware, it's not just like a exclusive club just for Halehiva people.
No.
We want everybody to be able to come here at some point.
Yeah.
And so reach out because, you know, there's always an opportunity.
Yeah.
What's your favorite thing to do when you guys are out here on the farm?
Well, right now it's growing ipu. It's my,
really,
first time growing ipu.
Those are the gourds.
Yeah. The gourds.
You
cannot eat them,
yeah,
but I used to dance hula,
okay,
so it kind of brings me back to like my childhood.
Right. I mean, that's so amazing to me that you guys are able to not only reach back and teach the kids about what's going on now and how it's relevant in their lives now, but also what it meant, how we got here.
Yes.
How the agriculture is so important to our past culture, obviously,
yeah,
our culture now. But thank you so much for coming on the show,
Anna. Thank you, Brooke.
Good luck with all the ipus. Maybe,
yes,
we're going to see them at Merry Monarch Monday. We don't know.
Not this year.
Well, thanks for coming on.
Thank you.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Modern Wahine, Hawaii. You can see we're still at the farm, I promise you, but we're in the store portion. I'm here with Sarah McGuigan, who is, tell me again your title, because it's very special.
The director of social enterprise.
Social enterprise, that's what caught me. But I was like, social, I thought maybe social media. Nope, social enterprise here in the store. So tell us a little bit about your world here. What's going on? What's new? What's shaking?
Yeah. Well, welcome back and thank you for coming back. So what's new since you've been here last is our bulk refill bar. Mm-hmm. So the bulk refill bar was always a vision for this to be kind of like the core of our store.
Right.
So here it is.
Ta-da!
It's launched.
Yeah.
We carry several cleaning products, laundry products, bath and body, hair, and the whole thing here is you come in, bring in your own container, or you're welcome to you know, purchase one of the glass that we have here and right. refill your jar right. or bottle. And so that it completely eliminates plastic use in your home when you refill one of those products.
Yeah, so I mean, the whole process of it is to not have to keep buying plastic things that hold it. You bring your own thing back and you refill it and then you just head on your merry way.
Yes.
Which is a lot closer if you live in this area than like having to drive all across the freeway to go somewhere and pick it up.
So right, it's a lot totally. Easier.
And the products you swear by because you yes. use them and they're really good.
Yeah, and so that's the other component. Not only are you eliminating that plastic bottle,
right.
but the products that we have, they're all non-toxic ingredients. Mm-hmm. They have all been vetted and are very high quality, and so the cost that you're spending, you will save money buying these more organic,
right.
non-toxic products than you would in another store. Mm-hmm. And then we are sourcing as locally as possible.
That's the key part.
Yes.
So you're buying local even for that aspect of it, right?
Correct. In our laundry powder, in our lotions, our face washes, our shampoo, conditioners, body wash, and hand soap, those are all coming locally.
Nice.
So,
nice. Yeah, right here in and around the island.
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about, because you know, the storefront is doing amazing. You guys are open 3 days a week now.
Yeah.
For people to come in, but there is a direct line of connection between the farm, which is right behind, and the store, right? You want to talk about that?
Yes, definitely. So I think what we find most exciting is when we're able to make that connection between the mission here that we're supporting in the general store, which is, you know, bringing a low waste lifestyle to the community, with what we're doing on the farm,
right.
On the learning farm, and that educational component. So, you know, where we kind of can create that synergy tangibly mm-hmm. is in the products that we carry.
Yes.
And so one of our best selling items is our Olena soap bar. Mm. That's Olena that we harvested from the learning farm.
Right.
We literally brought it home, juiced it, took the pulp, dehydrated it, brought that pulp to the North Shore Soap Factory in the Waialua Sugar Mill.
Right around the corner. Right.
And they made it into a soap bar. And that Olena pulp is an exfoliant.
Oh, okay.
And it's our best-selling bar. It sells itself. Mm. And then when we tell people that it's from our farm, whether they want to gift it or they want to use it themselves, and it's super exciting for both the farm team and us to have it do so well.
Right.
And so just creating more of those synergies, our next step is actually creating a beauty row.
That's what I heard.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that was actually at the request of one of our local skincare makers, Aim High, Auntie Betty. She also works out at Sugar Mill. That's where her lab is. But she makes amazing products and she loves to source from the islands as much as possible. Mm-hmm. But we're actually going to be growing like hibiscus and lavender that we can harvest for her and she can infuse in her stuff. So
nice.
So we just want to grow those partnerships, grow that connection to the farm, and the products do really well. So it's like win-win-win.
And then supporting the entrepreneurship too, because even Anna was saying, you know, it's like with the interns that come through, you don't necessarily want to have to grow up to be a farmer.
Right.
But you're here and you're learning certain things, like how to be an entrepreneur, things that you can do with it, you know, side jobs that come out of it. Like there's a whole other industry that just comes from not only just getting your hands dirty, but all of the other things that happen with it. So it's sort of a cascading effect, which is awesome.
Yes.
So you've been here, you're kind of new to the team, right?
Yes.
The store has been around for a while, but you know, you guys are sort of expanding along with the rest of the farm. How's it been here?
So it's been amazing. Like I think for me, it's definitely a dream job. I think retail with a purpose.
Right.
You know, I'm super passionate about retail. I love it. But to find purpose in it is hard. So to be able to be in this place and do that, for me, what's been most amazing is not just the mission that we support and the fact that all of our proceeds go back into the foundation 100%, but it is actually bringing in those vendor partnerships, mm-hmm. creating, you know, like just proliferating this local economy yeah. of sustaining ourselves, sustaining the artists, mm-hmm. sustaining the makers, and like having, building those relationships and those conversations are the best part of my
right.
job.
Right, nice. Well, congratulations on everything that's been happening. You know, when we first came out here, we're deep into the pandemic and, you know, everything was sort of not asleep, but in a stasis because, you know, people couldn't congregate, you know, waiting on permits and all that kind of thing. To see the blossoming and the bubbling up that has happened here at the farm and all of the outreach that has happened and all the clearing and the lo'i and everything, it's just amazing that, you know, no matter what, anything about what you're talking about, Jacqueline Johnson and, you know, Kōkua Hawaii Foundation, they find a way.
Yeah.
They will find a way.
Yeah. Like,
it might not be the way they thought, but never give up, never surrender.
Yeah.
And we will figure out a way. And so this is amazing to see because the last time we came, they're like, we're going to do bulk. It's not happening right now because we have to figure out, you know, the sourcing and bringing in all of these large, where are we going to house it? How is it going to work? And then we come back and boom, here it is. So people can come right down here and, you know, jump right in feet first and get themselves vested in it. So thank you for all of your work that you do here and keeping this hub all going and bubbling strong. And we're just glad that you're part of the team. And thanks for having us into your hub over here.
Yeah, thank you for coming and letting me talk about it. I can talk about it all day. So.
Well, that's our show for today, Hawaii, here on the North Shore at Kōkua Hawaii Foundation Farm. We're so excited to be able to come out here and see all of the progress that's been happening out here on the North Shore. Mahalo to all the women that came on the show today, to Natalie McKinney and Anna Mathis, as well as my girl, Sarah McGuigan, here in the store. We've had so much fun talking to everybody. It's so exciting to be able to be part of something that has been growing and growing, and it's just snowballing and snowballing. Please check out the tickets that are available for the July shows for, you know, Kōkua Foundation. Help out if you can. There's still some tickets available. But also come down here and check out the farm because you could come on a community weekend. You could come and get involved with the bulk shopping experience here. They also have some lovely vintage things. So come and check them out. And please, Kōkua, because everything that they're doing here is going right back into the schools and helping the keiki here on the aina. So it's all a give back and a kākou kind of thing. Thank you again for watching the show. Make sure, you know, we mask up, socially distance when you can. We're getting through all of it. And I'll see all of you next week.